Hi.
A week ago or so, I saw on YouTube that fellow YouTuber Spellerine, I'm not sure about the pronunciation there. I had put together some record collection questions for other record collectors to answer and make videos about. So I thought it was a very good idea. And here comes my questions. There are 12 questions to answer here. First of all, your most elusive record. And, well, there are lots of elusive records, and many of them are so elusive that I haven't even been able to find them yet. But this is one of them. This was a very elusive record. It's Skip Batten's solo album. Skip Batten, mainly known from The Birds. I found the single, the St. Louis Browns and Central Park, maybe 15 years ago, and then I wanted, well, I liked it, I like this. I wanted the LP as well, but I searched and I searched and I searched, but I recently found it. It was another record collecting friend who knew that I was looking for this, who told me that he had seen it and even told the store owner to put it away so that I'd be able to buy it later. So, very kind of him. So, now I got that. But it was a very elusive record. Right, move on. Your most valuable record. Well, value and value, you know. You can never really tell what is valuable and what is not valuable. But this one, Axelsson, Swedish progressive music, an LP called Spår from the early 70s. When I found it, I had no idea what it was, and I only paid, well, a very small sum for this, mainly because I was very curious about it. But then I recently found out that it's very, very rare, and some lots of people really want this. So, and I've seen it been sold for quite high prices. I don't know whether this is my most valuable record, but it is probably one of the more valuable ones. Okay, record you pay the most for. Well, it's very hard to understand and remember all the money I spent on records, but this recent I bought this quite recently at a record fair in Solna. It is the first album of the pop group The Streeplers from 1964. This group is still playing together today, but they are more of a Swedish dance band today. I paid quite a big sum for this because it is not that simple to find. Okay, I won't tell you how much I paid for it though. Weirdest thing you found in a sleeve? Well, I don't know if I found that many weird things, but I found this rather weird thing in this 10-inch LP. British issue, Decca, of songs by Tom Lehrer. First of all, somebody had written down all the lyrics on an ordinary typewriter, not on a computer. And then someone has, maybe probably the same person, has put together dictionary or word lists, vocabularies of all, well, some of the strange words that appear in these lyrics and a Swedish pronunciation. So this record was once used to learn some English and become better at English, and I can't think of any better lyrics to use to improve your English than Tom Lehrer's. Okay. Awesome-horrible cover art. Well, awesome cover art. Well, I'm not really a fan of Jerry Lewis, but this children/comedy record Cinderfella is quite something. Doesn't look that special, but if you open it, you find a board game, or well, a Cinderfella game, with instead of some sort of dice, you have this spinning spinning arrow, and here you have things to use when you play the game, cutouts, and the whole story in a little book like this. So, quite a nice record here. And I have to show you the... Check my beauty for some seconds here. Have a look on the vinyl. It's beautiful. In blue, red, yellow, green. Yeah. I don't think the actual contents on this record is that very impressive, but it's a delightful record to have. Okay, most horrible cover art. Well, be prepared for this. Female pop singer Birgitta Wallgård sings Ställd mot väggen, a record on the Polar label. Birgitta Wallgård was backup singer to ABBA, and she also had her own orchestra. And this is quite a good record. I like the music on it, but the cover art isn't that beautiful. Not that flattering for her. Okay, mispressing. Well, I got lots of that, but I found this recently. It's a 78 RPM on Capitol Americana. It says Shame on You by Jack Guthrie on one of the sides, and it says Oklahoma Hills by Jimmy Wakely. And they have mixed the two singers, so it's Jack Guthrie who sings Oklahoma Hills, and it's Jimmy Wakely who sings Shame on You, so they they mixed them there. That's a mispressing. Autographed records. I don't really have that many autographed records, but I have this one. It's a children's record with a children favorite, the doll Televinken, and his female friend Anita. And here it says in Swedish, Björn på femårsdagen, grattis från Anita och Televinken. To Björn on his fifth birthday, congratulations from Televinken and Anita. And, well, if you know, my name is Björn, but it isn't dedicated to me. But I found it in a flea market somewhere many, many years ago, so I couldn't resist it. Okay, I think we have to split this video into two parts, so we'll continue in the second part of this list, record collection questions part 2.